Scott and Rachel. Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Bexley United Methodist. Let's go ahead and stand and sing our first song together. He reigns. It's the song of the redeemed, rising from the African plain. It's the song of the forgiven, drowning out the Amazon rain. The song of Asian believers filled with God's holy fire. It's every tribe, every tongue, every nation, a love song born of a grateful choir. It's all God's children singing glory, glory, hallelujah, he reigns, he reigns. It's all God's children singing glory, glory, hallelujah, he reigns, he reigns. Let it rise above the four winds, caught up in the heavenly sound. Let praises echo from the towers of cathedrals to the faithful gathered underground. Of all the songs sung from the dawn of creation, well, some were meant to persist. Of all the bells rung from a thousand steeples, well, none rings truer than this. It's all God's children singing glory, glory, hallelujah, he reigns, he reigns. It's all God's children singing glory, glory, hallelujah, he reigns, he reigns. And the powers of darkness tremble at what they've just heard, 'cause the powers of darkness can't drown out a single word. When all God's children sing out glory, glory, hallelujah, he reigns, he reigns. It's all God's children singing glory, glory, hallelujah, he reigns, he reigns. All God's children singing glory, glory, hallelujah, he reigns, he reigns. It's all God's children singing glory, glory, well, hallelujah, he reigns.
Welcome to worship. I'm not going to do too many announcements today. This is All Saints Sunday, and we're going to have a little bit more liturgy than normal. And so just follow along. I'll tell you what to do. It's a special day because we give thanks for people who have passed from the church militant. The church, Martin Luther said, is still working and struggling here on earth, into the church triumphant, and are in the presence of Jesus. And so we have a beautiful day to celebrate. And most of our announcements are in the bulletin. One thing I will tell you is that we've started our vision process, and next newsletter on Friday, there's going to be a link to an online survey that you can take to participate in the vision process. And we want to hear from everyone who wants to share something. So please, please, every voice is important. So please take advantage of that opportunity. And now let's continue in a spirit of worship.
I love you, Lord. Oh, your mercy never fails me. All my days I've been held in your hands. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, I will sing of the goodness of God. All my life you have been faithful, and all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. I love your voice. You have led me through the fire. In darkest night, you are close like no other. I've known you as a father, I've known you as a friend. I have lived in the goodness of God. All my life you have been faithful, and all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. With my life laid down, I'm surrendered now, I give you everything. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. And all my life you have been faithful, and all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath you have been made, I will sing of the goodness of God. I will sing of the goodness of God.
Sometimes I fall to my knees and pray, come, Jesus, come. Let today be the day And sometimes I feel like I'm gonna break, but I'm holding on to hope that won't fail. And come, Jesus, come. We've been waiting so long for the day you return to heal every hurt and right every wrong. We need you right now. And come and turn this around. 'Cause deep down I know this world isn't home. So come, Jesus, come. Come, Jesus, come. There'll be no war, and there'll be no chains when Jesus comes. Today be the day He'll come for the weak and the strong just the same, and all will believe in the power of His name. So come, Jesus, come. We've been waiting so long for the day you return to heal every hurt, right every wrong. We need you right. Come and turn this around. 'Cause deep down I know this world isn't home. So come, Jesus, come. Come, Jesus, come. One day. We'll stand face to face. Come lay it all down. 'Cause it might be today. The time is right now. There's no need to wait. Your past will be washed by rivers of grace. So come, Jesus, come. We've been waiting so long for the day you return to heal every hurt and right every wrong. We need you right now. Come and turn this around. 'Cause deep down I know this world isn't home. So come, Jesus, come. Come, Jesus, come. Come, Jesus, come. Come, Jesus, come.
You may be seated.
Good morning. Oh, you're already here. Can all the children come up? All right. How is everybody? All right. So, good morning, everyone. Let's say our favorite Bible verse together. You ready? This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Okay. All right. I've got three great riddles for you this morning. So, let's get started. You ready? Riddle number one. What is the most musical part of the turkey? What's the most musical part of the turkey?
The harp.
That's a good guess. Not quite right.
A candle.
What's the most musical part of a turkey?
Bone.
All right. I'm going to give you the answer. These are good guesses.
The legs of the toes.
The legs. You know what? I'm going to give it to you. The answer is the most musical part of the turkey is the drumstick. All right. Riddle number two. Why did the turkey cross the road? Anyone? Why did the turkey cross the road? Yes.
To get to the other side.
Get to the other side. That's good. That's why the chicken crossed the road. But why did the turkey cross the road?
Because he had legs.
Because he had legs? Good guess. One more.
Because he had a beak with it. A beak on his head.
A beak? All right, I'm going to give you the answer. You ready? Why did the turkey cross the road? To prove he wasn't chicken. All right, last one. Why did the police take the turkey in for questioning? Anyone? Why did the turkey take the police in for questioning? All right, it's always fun to hear what we get here.
Because he wanted to cross the road.
Because he was the key to the suspects.
That's a good guess. All right, I'm going to give you the answer. Number three, why did the police take the turkey in for questioning? They suspected foul play. All right. All right, everybody ready? We're going to talk for a minute here. Okay, so I picked these riddles for today because we're now in the month of November, right? This is November? Everyone know that? Okay, and that means we're getting closer to what day in November?
Thanksgiving.
Excellent. So what are you thankful for? Just shout out what you're thankful for.
Shout out.
My family.
Okay, family. Yeah.
I'm thankful for my mom and dad and my cousin.
Oh, good.
I thank you for turkey.
Turkey, all right.
All right, lots of things to be thankful for. Okay. Well, I'm thankful for many things, and I'm thankful for you, for all of you. And I probably don't say that often enough. It's so great to see you here at church, and I appreciate that you come up here each week and listen to my bad riddles. So I'm thankful for you. And I'm also thankful to God for all the wonderful things that he's done for me. Let me be quiet for a minute, okay? Thank you. So I'm also thankful to God for all the wonderful things he's done for me and for all of us. So it's so important to express our gratitude. Okay, we're going to be quiet, okay? Can you listen for just a few minutes? Thank you. Okay. So I want each of you to do something for me this week. Each morning this week, when you wake up and before you get out of bed, I want you to say, thank you, God, for giving me this day. Can you say that? Thank you, God, for giving me this day. And I'm going to do it too. Every morning when I wake up, that's the first thing I'm going to try to remember. That's the first thing I'm going to say. And maybe we can get your parents to do it too. So ask your parents if they did it in the morning too. Okay, can you do that for me? It's a great way to start the day by giving God thanks. All right, we're going to sing a song. Which is going to come up on the screen, I think. There it is. All right, and we're going to sing this to Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star. What do you think? Okay. All right, here we go. Ready? When you wake, here's what to do. Give to God a big thank you. He's given you another day to learn and laugh and love and play. When you awake, here's what to do. Give to God a big thank you. Okay. All right. We're going to say our prayer. Are you ready? Let's put our hands. We're going to pray. Okay. All right. We're going to be quiet when we pray. Are you ready? Okay. Repeat after me, please. Dear God, we are so very thankful for all your blessings. Thank you for today and every day. Amen. Amen. All right, you can go to Sunday school. And the rest of us can stand up and greet each other.
No one else will say it. So hard to get people in a pattern. It's terrible. Are there joys and concerns you'd like to share today? Yeah, Cheryl. For Kate's continued healing and recovery, and also for parents agonizing. Just a second. Lord, hear our prayers. And yes, James, go ahead.
Good to be back in the house of the Lord.
It is good to be back in the house of the Lord. Lord, hear our prayers. Thanksgiving. Yeah, Steve.
Pam's favorite Uncle Chuck passed away Friday. So prayers for his family.
Oh. For Chuck's family, and especially for Pam, as they are grieving his passing. And it's good to be here on All Saints Day. If you have another saint to celebrate, and remember. So for that family and for their comfort, Lord, hear our prayers. Yeah, just.
A friend of mine recently, he and his sister recently got a really bad golf club accident. One of them was home until life to death situation. But they both are significant recovery, but still some days.
For Justin's friend and his sister who were in a golf cart accident that was pretty serious, right? For their recovery, Lord, hear our prayers. And it's made it through. So for thanks and some thanks, right? For David, who made it through a four-wheeler accident, and has scoliosis now. But yes, for David, it's a joy and a concern too. So Lord, hear our prayers. Our drummer Larry Hinton is still recovering from his surgery. And so let's keep Larry's healing in our prayers. Lord, hear our prayers.
I and the team will be leaving Thursday evening for Havana to get to this
meeting. For Sharon's and team's mission trip to Havana, and for their safety, and for also them to be powerful bearers of God's love and hope, Lord, hear our prayers. Anything else? Okay. St. Paul encouraged the church in Corinth, and I think his words still speak to us, that when before you have communion, it's good to do some self-examination. So it's something I like to do on communion Sundays, that we do a prayer of confession. And I oftentimes just work it into the prayer. But I wanted to do something a little different this Sunday. I found a prayer of confession that's based on the Beatitudes from Jesus' Sermon on the Mount, and I thought we'd do that together. Can you put that up, Kyle? We don't normally do this in this service, but... So I'll play the part of the liturgist, and you do the part with me in bold. You have said that the poor in spirit are blessed, yet we pretend to be powerful and pursue the lie of self-sufficiency. Give us humble hearts and help us depend on your grace and goodness for every moment. O humble God, we need you. You have said that those who mourn are blessed, yet we would often rather numb ourselves through movies and media then open ourselves to the reality of grief in the world and in our hearts. Help us look up from our phones toward you and give us strength to be present in pain. O comforting God, we need you. You have said that the meek are blessed, yet we follow the call of advertisements and corporate ladders pursuing the treasures of this world. Help us steward our earthly blessings well and find our true treasure in you. O generous God, we need you. You have said that those who desire righteousness and justice are blessed, yet we are so easily lulled into the comfort of complacency. Fill us with your spirit that we might flee from sin and fight for your justice. O holy God, we need you. You have said that the merciful are blessed, yet we harbor anger and resentment in our hearts. Heal our bitterness, teach us to forgive, and help us work toward restoration in our lives and world. O merciful God, we need you. You have said that the pure in heart are blessed, yet we go about our days with mixed motives, sometimes of service, and sometimes of selfishness. Purify our hearts and help us to be people of integrity and honesty. O present God, we need you. You have said that the peacemakers are blessed, yet we live in a polarized world where it is easier to take sides than build bridges. Give us ears to humbly listen and tongues seasoned with grace, that we might carry your non-anxious presence through the world. Oh, Father God, we need you. Forgive us our sin, O God. Renew us, refresh us, rebuild our lives so that they are reflections of your love for all people. We pray in the name of Jesus, the source of all blessings. There is a wideness in God's mercy like the wideness of the sky. In the name of Jesus Christ, we are forgiven. Amen. Our scripture for this morning is from 1 John chapter 3, verses 1 through 3. See what love the Father has given us that we should be called children of God, and that is what we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we will be has not yet been revealed. What we do know is this: when he is revealed, we will be like him, for we will see him as he is. And all who have this hope in him purify themselves just as he is pure. Let's see. Do your parents sometimes make you come to church? Yeah.
Let me tell you about something. This was the first ever time that I have actually been to church by myself.
Woo! Boom! Yeah, so most of us have had some experience, not all of us, but some of us have had some experience of somebody making us come to church, like a parent. And do you ever wonder why they do that? I want to take a guess at a couple reasons. One, I think parents, and it's maybe a mixture and maybe different for different people, but one is, I think they want you to learn to be a good person, a moral person. They want you to learn the Ten Commandments and kind of live a moral life. Two, they want you to get to know some other people who are doing that, trying to do the same thing, and build some community around that and encourage each other. Three, they probably know some adults whose lives are really centered on themselves, and they're always trying to find more things and more excitement and more possessions, and they seem strangely empty and unhappy, and they don't want you to do that. They want your God hole to be filled so that you can be who you're meant to be. And I think there's one other reason that I think is what John is getting at in this very first sentence. So our translation said, see what manner of love God has given us, that we're children of God. I think the King James Version actually in this case has it better. It says, behold. It's a big deal. Behold what manner of love the Father has given us that we should be children of God. I think parents on some level, and they kind of affirm this when they baptize infants, parents, as they love you so much. They stay up nights when you're sick. They make job choices, maybe not even the happiest job choices, so they can provide for you what's best. They think about you all the time. You don't know this, but they are thinking about you all the time. And yet, they know that as much as they love you, they believe there is a source of even greater love, a source of greater love for you that knows you even better than they know you, and maybe even better than you know yourself. One who was willing to lay it all on life for you. And they just don't want you to go through life not knowing about the chance to have that relationship with someone who knows and loved you that much. Parents also, I think, maybe not in the early years, but you start to get aware of your own mortality and you want to make sure, gosh, you're kind of being a stand-in God protector, lover, carer, forgiver for your children. But at some point we know most children are going to live past their parents, and we want you to know that heavenly parent that is available to all of us for a source of love, forgiveness. And by the way, they wonder, you know, life being what it is, full of temptations, full of difficult choices, they know you may be facing temptations and troubles and make mistakes. They want you to know about forgiveness and second chances. And they believe the unique things they see in you are God-given gifts, and those gifts are best realized when they are offered to God. God develops people in such beautiful ways. Behold, what manner of love God has given, that we should be called children of God. Now, I think modern people stumble on this a little bit because we think, well, God made everybody. God loves everybody. Yes, amen. God is the creator for everyone, and each person is loved by God. It's different to, that's, God is the creator by nature of all people and has a connection. All people are made in God's image. But the image of God is subject to kind of some of the fall of creation that it's kind of distorted. In the world around us, we inherit it, we see it, we're shaped by it, and so it has to kind of get rebuilt within us. And that image of God, which is in all of us, for people who have felt by grace God's call on their life and know that they're children of God, it's like you go from having someone who's your paternity, someone who's been found in a paternity suit to be your father, and someone who's actually the father, who's in relationship with you, who's helping raise you, who's loving you and leading you and caring about you. So we're children of God. And we probably don't talk about that enough. It's just a wonderful blessing to be part of God's family. It's a wonderful blessing to have God, the ground of all being, the creative source of the universe, it sounds crazy, cares and knows you and me, and we can live into that truth. A second thing I think John is trying to, The second thing I think John is trying to help us see is that he's definitely alluding back to that portion of the very first story that's told in the scriptures, that God made humanity in God's image. And I think he's trying to affirm that our destiny, our true fulfillment, is to keep growing in awareness of what it means to be a child of God. And it's a process. It happens throughout our lives. And this promise that someday we'll be in God's presence, we'll see God, and we'll be perfected by being in God's presence, we'll be purified by being in God's presence, as we've kind of been in process all along, that is not just for the Mother Teresa's of the world. You can be someone bearing God's image and growing in that grace, no matter if you can be someone with a ton of education, someone with no education, you can be a business person, you can be a stay-at-home domestic engineer, you can be a custodian, you can be a counselor, you can live in a mansion, you can live in a tent, you can be cultivating and growing in Christ-likeness in many, many stages and ages. and stations of life. It's simply about living into that wonderful connection that God offers to us as children of God. And in the Orthodox Church, I've been using more and more visual things up here because so many people are visual learners, I keep finding out. I'm not that much, but so many people are. In the Orthodox version of Christianity, iconography is very important. Icons, pictures of Jesus, and they're painted in a specific way to draw our eyes into the gaze of Christ. And they believe that seeing really, really shapes us. Seeing puts us in connection with Jesus. We lots of times think studying, learning, knowing, but seeing can put us in connection with Jesus. I lots of times with people that we're doing the premarital stuff with, want them to tell me about their parents and their parents' marriage, because not very many parents actually talk to their children about marriage relationships, but children learn a ton just by seeing their parents, right? That's, in fact, probably the way we really learn the things most deeply that we that sneak up on us. We don't even know how we came to know them, is by seeing things every day. Seeing Jesus every day through the stories of Scripture, through worship, and what we see in Christians who are growing in God's likeness, one another. Seeing helps shape us. And then the third affirmation in this little scripture is that someday, and it's kind of agnostic about what form that's going to take. Doesn't talk about necessarily Jesus coming on a cloud from the heavens. Doesn't necessarily talk about last day of judgment. Kind of just saying someday we'll see him as he is. And then we will be who we are meant to be. And a lot of the scriptures will go on in the book of Revelation and talk about heaven being this incredible place where there's no more tears and no more weeping and no more sighing. And it's simply because we're all in the presence of Christ and we're illuminated and shaped by the light of God's love. And it's just a wonderful thing to look forward to. Not that we want to get there any sooner than our time, but it's a good, good gift. We lift up today All Saints Day. We celebrate God's love, God's mercy, his patience with us as we grow in his likeness, and the ultimate promise of being in God's presence. And someday, God willing, that will be our lot, to be in that happy, blessed place. Amen. In the United Methodist understanding of communion, it's an open table and everyone is welcome to receive. And should have. Jesus said, come to me, all you who are weary and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for my yoke is easy and my burden is light, and you will find rest for your souls. So hear these words of thanksgiving. Kyle, can you? This is liturgy also. With all the saints, we praise you, O God, for creating the worlds. With all the baptized, the young and the old, the weak and strong, famous and forgotten, we bless you, O God, for providing us with food. With all the faithful and tents and mansions, cities and farms, past and present, we worship you, O God, for sheltering the generations. With all your holy people who minister in the church, who serve the poor, who walk the way of the cross, we glorify you, O God, for journeying with us in Jesus. With Paul and the evangelist, we remember the meal of your Son. On the night when he died, he took bread and gave thanks and broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for remembrance of me." And again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it to all to drink, saying, "This is my blood of the new covenant, poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." With Peter and all the martyrs, we honor Christ's death, saying, "Amen. Amen." With Mary Magdalene and all the apostles, we proclaim his resurrection, shouting, "Amen.
Amen."
With John, the theologians, and the mystics, we celebrate Christ present with us. Amen. With the Virgin Mary, who sang of your greatness, we pray for the power of the Spirit. Imbue this gathering, this bread and this cup, with the merciful body and blood of Christ. Form us into a communion of service and infuse your earth with the wholeness we seek. We rejoice today that we share this holy meal, surrounded by a great cloud of witnesses who have gone on before us and with whom we will feast at your heavenly banquet. David? Today we especially give thanks for Robert Henshaw, for Robert Mike Huggins, for Linda Maroos, for David Heddleston, and for one who knows God's everlasting faithfulness through God's covenant with Moses, David Dockner. Now, with all the family you saved by your love, we praise and thank you and ascribe to you honor and glory now and forever. Amen. And now, with the confidence of the children of God, let us pray the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. The gifts of God for the people of God, you are invited to come, and will the ushers and helpers come forward too?
All right, everyone, let's rise and sing our last song, our going forth song. I will follow. Where you go, I'll go. Where you stay, I'll stay. When you move, I'll move. I will follow. Whoa. Whoa. All your ways are good, all your ways are sure. I will trust in you alone, higher than my sight, high above my life. I will trust in you alone. Where you go, I'll go. Where you stay, I'll stay. When you move, I'll move. I will follow you. Whom you love, I love. How you serve, I serve. If this life I lose, I will follow you. Yeah, I will follow you. Yeah. Light into the world, light into my life. I will live for you alone. You're the one I seek, knowing I will find all I need in you alone, in you alone. Where you go, I'll go. Where you stay, I'll stay. When you move, I'll move. I will follow you. Whom you love, I love. How you serve, I serve. If this life I lose, I will follow you. Yeah, I will follow you. Yeah. In you there's life everlasting. In you there's freedom for my soul. In you there's joy, unending joy. And I will follow. Where you go, I'll go. When you stay, I'll stay. When you move, I'll move. I will follow you. Whom you love, I love. How you serve, I serve. If this life I lose, I will follow you. Where you go, I'll go. Where you stay, I'll stay. When you move, I'll move. I will follow you. Whom you love, I love. How you serve, I serve. And if this life I lose, I will follow you. Yeah, I will follow you. Yeah, I will follow you. Yeah, I will follow you.
May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. May God lift up the light of his countenance upon you and give you peace. And may you be blessed to be a blessing in this world that God so loves. Amen.